Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
Amen.
In the water of the baptism, Mieczysław died with the Christ and rose with him to a new life. May he now share with him eternal glory. Let us pray. O God, Almighty Father, our faith professes that your Son died and rose again. Merciful granted through this mystery, your servant, Mieczysław, who has fallen asleep in Christ, may rejoice to rise again through him, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the Book of Wisdom. The souls of the just are in the hand of God, and no torment shall touch them. They seemed, in the view of the foolish, to be dead, and their passing away was thought an affliction, and their going forth from us utter destruction. But they are in peace. For if before men indeed they be punished, yet is their hope full of immortality. Chastised a little, they shall be greatly blessed, because God tried them and found them worthy of himself. As gold in the furnace, he proved them, and as sacrificial offerings, he took them to himself. In the time of their visitation, they shall shine, and shall dart about as sparks through stubble. They shall judge nations and rule over peoples, and the Lord shall be their king forever. Those who trust in him shall understand truth, and the faithful shall abide with him in love. Because grace and mercy are with his holy ones, and his care is with his elect. This is the word of the Lord. Not also give us everything else along with him. Who will bring a charge against God's chosen ones? It is God who acquits us. Who will condemn? It is Christ Jesus who died, rather, was raised, who also is at the right hand of God, who indeed intercedes for us. What will separate us from the love of Christ? Will anguish, or distress, or persecution, or famine, or nakedness, or peril, or the sword? No. In all these things we conquer overwhelmingly through him who loved us. For I am convinced that neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor present things, nor future things, nor powers, nor height, nor depth, nor any other creature will be able to separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus our Lord. This is the word of the Lord.
According to John. Jesus said to the crowds, "Everything that the Father gives me will come to me, and I will not reject anyone who comes to me, because I came down from heaven not to do my own will, but the will of the one who sent me. And this is the will of the one who sent me, that I should not lose anything of what he gave me, but that I should raise it on the last day. And this is the will of my Father, that everyone who sees the Son and believes in him may have eternal life, and I shall raise him on the last day." The Gospel of the Lord. My brothers and sisters, this morning we just come to the church, show our final respect by participating in the Holy Eucharist for our brother Mieczysław. In the beginning of my homily, I'd like to express deepest sympathy to their family on behalf of the death of our brother Mieczysław. We commend him to the merciful Lord Jesus Christ. My brothers and sisters, life is the full of the parting. No matter how close our relationship with our loved ones are, we still have to part with them time to time. Sometimes we know the parting is very painful. The closest the bond we have with someone, and the longer the period of the separation is likely to be, the more we feel the pain of the parting. Why is the parting so painful? Because it is only when we have to part with the people that we realize how much we loved them. In effect, the full worth of the friend may not come apparent to us until she or he has actually gone from us. Now, what is the truth of the ordinary parting is even truer of the parting we call death. Death is the most irrevocable parting of all. This time our loved one will not return to our earthly life. My brothers and sisters, this is why we come to church, because we believe that our life ends but is not changed but is not ended. What we profess, Jesus Christ prepared for each one of us everlasting home in heaven. And the Gospel shows us also that Jesus shared with us the pain of the dying and the parting with his friends. His friends, for their part, were plunged in a gloom as they thought of his living. But he also told them, "You have sorrow now, but I will see you again, and your heart will rejoice." In other words, death would not be the everlasting parting. Holy Eucharist reminds us that Even though our body will die one day, we have prepared by Jesus Christ everlasting home in heaven. This is faith is kind of our compass in during the journey of our life. We here doesn't have an everlasting home. How many times we change our address, our homes? So whatever we're trying to build as a permanent, never be permanent, because we don't have here everlasting homes. We're kind of the pilgrimage. Homo viator, a human who always in the process of the journey. We never be satisfied what we're doing. And Jesus Christ, He gave us a perspective. He gave us the home, everlasting home for us, people who believe in God, in His resurrection. Every funeral mass is a, first of all, our celebration of the victory of the Jesus Christ over death in His resurrection. And we also participating in this resurrection. What we are reading in the first, in the second reading of the St. Paul to the Romans, if God is for us, who can be against us? It's a beautiful moment of the Messiah of the Handel when the soprano singing this, repeating, if God is for us, who can be against us? This is a truth we just have to remind ourselves during the Holy Eucharist. But it's not only sentimental reminding. This is a reality which awaits for each one of us. Funeral is mostly for our living, remind about our destination, how we should use the remaining time in a wise, sensitive way, not wasting it. Time is for us the gift given by us, by our Creator, to use for love. We commend our brother Mieczysław today to merciful Lord Jesus Christ. We commend to His mercy, because we know that as a human being we make many mistakes, but we believe that Jesus Christ's mercy is bigger than our limitation and our sinfulness. Our loved ones who gone before us have not disappeared in a nothingness. This is what we confirm. All the symbols in the Holy Eucharist, symbol of this Paschal candle, remind us that Jesus Christ is our light. We follow Him to eternal life, to our final destination. And they departed for the other shore, the shore of eternity. They have merely gone to God, and God is always very near to us. Brothers and sisters, Jesus Christ is risen from the dead and sits at the right hand of the Father, where He intercedes for His church. Confident that God hears the voices of those who trust in the Lord Jesus, we join our prayers to His. In the baptism, Mieczysław received the light of the Christ, scattered the darkness now, and led Him over the waters of death. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
Our brother Mieczysław was nourished at the table of the Savior. Welcome him into the halls of the heavenly banquet. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Many friends and the members of our families have gone before us and await the kingdom. Grant them an everlasting home with your Son. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Many people died with them by the violence, war, and the famine each day. Show your mercy to those who suffer so unjustly these sins against your love, and gather them to the eternal kingdom of peace. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the families and the friends of the Mieczysław, seek the comfort and the consolation. Heal their pain and dispel the darkness and the doubt that comes from their grief. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We are assembled here in the faith and the confidence to pray for our brother Mieczysław, strengthen our hope so that we may live in the expectation of your Son's coming. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And also let us pray for the peace in the world, especially in the Ukraine. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
In silence of our heart, let us commend, merciful Lord, our own intentions. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord God, giver of peace and healer of souls, hear the prayers of the Redeemer Jesus Christ, and the voices of your people, whose lives were purchased by the blood of the Lamb. Forgive the sins of all who sleep in Christ and grant them place in the kingdom. Through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Była cicha i piękna jak wiosna, żyła prosto, zwyczajnie jak my. Ona Boga na świat nam przyniosła i na ziemi wśród łez nowe dni zajaśniały.
Sacrificial offerings, O Lord, for the salvation of your servant Mechiswa, we beseech your mercy that he who did not doubt your Son to be loving Savior may find in him a merciful judge who lives and reigns forever and ever. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is
truly right and just our duty and our salvation always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him the hope of the blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful, O Lord, life is changed, not ended. And when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so the angels and archangels, with the thrones and the dominions, with all the hosts and the powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim. Upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and offer your resurrection until you come.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and the resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the blood and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with the Francis, our Pope, and Alan, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember your servant Mieczysław, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that he who has united with your Son in death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, and with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the Saint Joseph, her chaste husband, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be cursed to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. The sacred command, and from my divine teaching, we dare to say, "Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil." Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Thank you.
pray. Lord God, whose Son led us in the sacrament of his body, full from the journey, merciful granted, threatened by our brother Mieczysław, may come to the eternal table of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen. Good morning. Thank you all for coming. Most of you know me. I'm John Janusz. I'm Mike's little brother. That's what he used to call me. We didn't live that close together, so when I did get a chance to see him, he always said, "Hey, little brother." When we were at functions together and he introduced me to someone, he always introduced me as his little brother. Never kid brother, never younger brother. Little brother. Although, if we stood next to each other, arguably, I was at least a half inch taller. Mike was born in England, October of 1949. Her parents, Veronica and Kazimierz. Mike, his older sister, Misha, and I were raised in what was best described as a Polish post-war relocation or resettlement camp. We arrived in America in 1958, and the Świdwińskis befriended many other Polish, mostly immigrant families in the Detroit area. These families bonded by memberships in various Polish organizations, such as veterans groups, Polish schools, dance groups, and Hatzestwo. The children of these families became lifelong friends, and many of you are here for Mike today. In 1970, Mike enlisted in the U.S. Army, stationed at Fort Gordon, Georgia, and was a military policeman. As children, Mike always expressed an interest and an admiration in those types of positions of authority, such as policemen and the military. So his favorite television activities were John Wayne war movies, police shows. His favorite television shows, I believe, Saturday night were The Gallant Men and Combat. And I believe Sunday mornings, for those of you who may remember, a couple of shows, West Point and Annapolis. After he completed his service to his country, he graduated with a degree in criminal justice, so he was following that path that he loved. After that, he began working for the Federal Drug Enforcement Administration, probably his dream job. He fell in love with a Polish scout leader named Urszula Chojnacki. Urszula and Mike married, and that union brought to life two daughters, Anya and Lara. His DEA career then took him to Plymouth, Massachusetts, where he continued his duties with the DEA. In addition to drug interdiction duties at Boston's Logan Airport, he was also involved in the pursuit of notorious crime boss James Whitey Bulger. Many of you have probably heard that name. That assignment gave Mike a great deal of pride, as his life, quite literally, was in danger throughout the investigation. He indicated once that as part of the pursuit, he was on detail following him and trained his binoculars on Bulger and a couple of his henchmen. And out of the blue, one of the henchmen took out a pair of binoculars and trained them right on Mike. He was thrilled to be interviewed for the television program America's Most Wanted, where he discussed his involvement in that particular case. Thereafter, in 1990, the family was moved by the DEA to Virginia, where he headed a specialized training unit in drug interdiction at the FBI Academy in Quantico. His next DEA assignment relocated the family a little closer to home, to Grand Rapids, in 97, where Mike continued his work, like all of the children who were raised by my parents. We all had great work ethics. Didn't hurt that he loved his job, never taking a sick day. In 2008, unfortunate tragedy struck when his Ursula died when a tornado touched down close to the home. In spite of this, Mike continued working, and although the family endured challenging times, he kept at it, never gave up. The girls have grown into beautiful ladies and have married Anna to Brent Elkins and Laura to Justin Body. Laura and Justin gave Mike the best present ever when he became a grandfather, or to his beautiful grandson, Milo. Mike couldn't wait for him to grow a bit older so he could teach him how to fish and hunt. Mike ran into an old friend, Mary Jo Kaminski at Biała Wieża, the Polish scouting camp in Deckerville. Mary Jo had also lost her spouse, and they began reminiscing about their younger days. Mary Jo's husband, Les, and Mike grew up together. Mike and Mary Jo took solace in sharing comforting thoughts. They emailed, talked by phone, and eventually began dating. They both loved dancing and attended a number of Polish dances and New Year's Eve events. They also treasured their circle of friends. They also enjoyed traveling. Mike had no problem jumping into the car and driving all over the United States. They also traveled to Poland, and he often shared fond memories of that trip. He loved hunting, sailing, reading, cooking, and entertaining. He couldn't wait to go mushroom picking every fall. He loved having family and friends over for a good barbecue, especially 4th of July, many of you probably attended. He was a good cook and made sure no one went home hungry. He was extremely proud of his Polish heritage. He was a student of the culture and the history of Poland. A member of the Polish Heritage Society in Grand Rapids, he worked all year preparing for that city's annual Polish festival. Mike and Mary Jo manned the Polish Heritage Society tent at the festival for years. They acted as tour guides and proudly displayed Polish historical memorabilia from his personal collection during those three-day events. Going a little off script, personal note, very personal note, and you have to know me really, really well to understand the sense of pride I took in Mike at this particular time. October 8th, I got a text from Mary Jo. Now, Mike had already been diagnosed, he was already in treatment, and part of that treatment
involved dealing with therapists.
And I guess the therapist had asked Mike to name an animal starting with the letter O. And he said, orangutan. That was a great moment for me. I took such great pride, although probably for all the wrong reasons. So now I would like to close with a quote from Mike. It sums up his belief in his heritage. And it goes, Poles and Polish Americans have made some significant contributions to the world, and that should never be forgotten. So Mike, for your love of your Polish heritage, for your love of your lifelong friends, for your love of your girls, sons-in-laws, little Milo, your nieces and nephews, for your love for your family, and for your love of your wife, Mary Jo, you, my brother, will also be loved and never forgotten, and will forever remain in our hearts. On behalf of the entire family, once again, I thank you all for attending today's service. A luncheon will be held immediately following at the American Polish Cultural Center at the corner of 15 Mile and De Quinter. Once again, thank you.
Please stand up. Before we go our separate ways, let us take leave of our brother. May our farewell express our affection for him. May it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day we shall joyfully greet him again when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself. May the God give you drink from the fountain of eternal life. Your body was the temple of the Holy Spirit. You, Lord, will commend the soul of the images of your servant. In the sight of this world, he is now dead. In your sight, may he live forever. Forgive whatever sin he committed through the human weakness, and in your goodness, grant him everlasting peace. Through Christ, our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And
may the Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace.
Paradise. May they Thank you.